In this video, we're creating this 3D YouTube banner using Photopea, and we're going to change colors so that it looks maybe on blue, maybe green, whatever color. Join me. So first, you're going to access Photopea, the free online editor, using www.photopea.com, and you're going to access our PSD uploaded templates. You know, if you want to upload your own templates, you're more than welcome to. I've created a video of how to upload templates on here, and you can link it in the description below and learn how to help us with templates as well. Once you land on your templates, you're going to go to social media and click on YouTube, because we're doing YouTube today. Then you're going to type banner so that you get to view the templates that have already been loaded for YouTube banner. There's different kinds of gorgeous looking banners, most of them done by Cameron Cambit on YouTube. And he has amazing YouTube videos that teaches you how to create these graphic designs. Follow him. He has an amazing channel. Today we're going to be using the simple YouTube banner because it has a nice look and that 3D effect. All you do, you click on it so that it opens up the explanation in the description. I want to bring to your attention Cameron Cambit's video that he's added on here, the one that says tinyurl.com with that number. It's a link to his YouTube video telling you exactly how to edit the templates that he's added on here. So you're more than welcome to visit it. He teaches in such a calm, nice way. Anyway, once you're in, you're going to click on photopea.com and your template loads. It's very straightforward and easy. In order for you to change the name, you just double click on the name and then you type the name that you want the YouTube banner to have. So because we're using unboxing's name, we're going to use their name. I'm going to control A to select everything and just reduce the size and make it 180 so that it is manageable. Then I can move the name to exactly where I want to have it. Then you click on the correct mark and then you move it quite nicely like this. If you're not happy with the color of the template, then you can click on the hue on the tiny little box over there. You double click on there. And then you can adjust the hue and change it to the color that you want. So that's the easiest, laziest way that you can change the color. And Cameron showed us this on the video. So nice and easy. If you don't want to use the hue, then you can use or change the layers as it shows here. So I'm going to start with the name and double click on the name itself so that it opens up the layer style and I can adjust it. So I'm going to click where it says gradient overlay, and then I can go to gradient, and then I can adjust the color, because this is a manual change that I'm doing instead of that hue change. So when you click on the box, you're able to change the color and make whatever color that you want. I actually liked the blue, so I have a hex code for this. You just type in the hex code over there, or you move your color picker and then you're good to go. And then you change as you want. You click OK and the color gets adjusted. And you do exactly the same with the drop shadow. You see at the moment it's brownish yellow. So you double click on the drop shadow. You go to the color where it says normal and then you change the color there. And then it changed the color to the blue. And you would do exactly the same if you want to change the light spot, if you want to change the white light as well. I don't. I'm going to leave it alone. I do want to change the background. So I'm going to double click on background and I'm going to click on color overlay. Double click on color overlay and then select the color so that I can change the background to suit the blue theme that I'm going with here. See, when you're manually changing it, it adjusts it so nicely and you're able to tweak it and position it to the way that you want. I do actually want to add a picture, so I'm going to move the text layer and I'm going to click and add a picture that I've created from Canva, and I'm just gonna squeeze it nicely over there because this is unboxing. Usually unboxing is gifts, and so I created this nice three picture that I got from Canva. When you click on select, then the picture is added there. I think the only last thing that I would add, if I was creating a banner, I would want to tell people when to expect my videos. So what I'm going to do, I'm gonna go to my unblock the text blog and I'm gonna duplicate that layer, and then I'm gonna reduce the text of the duplicated layer, make that 100, and then type when people can expect my content. They know when to expect you to upload the videos. When you wanna change color, you do exactly the same like we just did, a bit lighter like that. All you do now, you download your design. You're gonna go file, export as PNG or whichever format that you prefer. I'm gonna go with PNG. You can rename it to call it YouTube banner, and then you download your design. If you want to learn more simple design, please subscribe to my channel. Please share so that you help me grow the channel. I do have super thanks as well. We can thank the channel by using our super thanks on the videos so that we continue growing, affecting a lot of people with the free content that we share on YouTube. Thank you for joining me today. I will see you on the next video. We'll be right back.